Hello, respected everyone.
Today we will talk about the modals. And here at the top I have written auxiliary verbs. These modals are used as the auxiliaries or as the helping verbs in the sentences. Either it is present tense, either it is tense, either it is voice, or it is narration. That is the direct and indirect speech that you sometimes call reported speech also. So there we use these all. Maximum cases we use all these models, and we should be very clear where to use, and at least one example if we get, we can easily understand where it will be used and how it will be used. So let's take one by one. I will be giving the examples. Please listen carefully. I will try my best to clear it. Now here I have written shall and will. This shall and will tells about the future happenings that can be done, and the same shall and will is used as should and would. Will is used as would and shall is used as should in the models. That's why I have written this shall and will to make you understand. Okay, so we can make it like this. To make you understand, I have written should and would. So total number is, now it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So total 8 portions we will decide and we will learn today. So let's come one. Can. So I can drink 10 liter water. I can drink 10 liter water. So this is the present quality, that I can drink 10 liters of water. But if I write here, I could drink 10 liters of water when I was 26 years old. So this is the capacity of the past, and here I have written I can drink 10 liter water. This is the capacity of the present. So to show the power of present we use can. To show the power of past we use could. And sometime we use could you please come here. Could you please come here. This is for the request also. So there are various usage of same models. Now we are coming to the may and might. Here see the example. May I ask you, this is the asking for permission, asking for request. May I ask you, may I come in, sir? So this is the request. Now we are coming for the might. He might come as he is ill. So here I have written he might come. He might come. The possibility is very less. Why? The reason is given. As he is ill, so there is very less possibility of coming. Now we are coming to the next. Would. How? Would you please shut the door? Would you please shut the door? This is the request. Some person is taking, asking for request, requesting another person to shut the door. So this is used for the permission. I mean, this is used for the request. When we request someone, we use would. Should. Should is used for advice. Sometimes it is used for advice. How? The doctor said, you should wake up early. You should wake up early. Here, this should is the advice given by the doctor. You should wake up early. Now we are coming to the ought to. Here it tells our moral. It tells our morality. Rama ought to obey her old parents. Here I have written Rama. So here I have written Rama ought to obey her old parents, and this ought to is telling about the moral responsibility, moral obligation. That's why we have used ought to. And here, after understanding the use of ought to, Rama ought to obey her old parents. This is the moral duty. We are coming to the next, that is need. This also tells our moral obligation. Like, you need not worry. You need not worry. I will take care. Need I attend the marriage? Here another thing. The moral responsibility. Should I attend? Is it that much necessary? Need I attend the marriage? Here the speaker is asking this. So this is the moral conscience, moral duty, moral obligation again. Now we are coming to the must. And must is the compulsion, I have told. He must study if he wants to become topper. So here must is used as a compulsion force. Because reason is there, if he wants to become the topper, he must study. One another example we can take. You must carry an umbrella. If you are walking out in the rain, it is compulsory, otherwise you will be dipped in water. So, it is compulsory to maintain the umbrella while it is the rainy season outside. The next we are coming to the have to and has to. This have to and has to is used in the present tense. Present tense. How? Like example I have again, the beggars have to. Beggars is the plural. So we are using have. The beggars have to walk long distance. So this is the present situation. When the beggar have to walk long distance to search some shelter on the footpath. Now, in spite of using beggars, if I use the beggar, singular, the beggar, then we will use had to. The beggar has to walk long distance. So this is only for the one beggar that we are using had to. And next we are coming had to. And this had to will tell about the past habit or past action that was done. The beggars had to walk long distance. The beggars had to. So this is about the past tense, when the beggars had to walk long distance to search the shelter to take rest during the night time. In this way, we can conclude that these are the modal auxiliaries, and these modal auxiliaries are used with the main verb in the sentences. And these you can easily understand when we are doing the tense, when we are doing the narration, that is reported speech, and when we are doing the voice. In these three parts of the grammar, basically these are used. So with these words, I hope you have understood. Thank you.